guys, check it out. If you're watching this video for the first time, you gotta know that this is our new giveaway, guys. This is our new giveaway. This is a 2024 GMC Sierra. Guys, at the beginning of the year, I bought three of these trucks. I bought the Ford F-150, the black GMC that we just gave away, and this one. Now, this may be the last dually that we gave away this year because they're getting harder and harder to find. So, if you guys been waiting for another dually giveaway, this is the time to get entered. The link is on the first comment, guys. This is a fully color matched truck by Pop Exclusive. It's a 2024 GMC dually 3500, and it is on 26-inch American Force wheel. Now guys, don't miss out. This is gonna be our 2-week giveaway. We have bundle packs for this giveaway, so go over there and shop today. Now, the giveaway on this truck, we have a bundle pack, and you already know we have a truck shirt. That truck shirt is only limited quantity, and we're only gonna sell it till it sells out, and we're never gonna restock ever again, guys. So go over there and shop right now. Like I said, the link is on the first comment. This is your chance to take home this badass dually. And if you don't want this dually, you can take home $50,000 in cash. Go over there and shop right now. Like I said, the link is on the first comment. Go, don't miss out.
$128.54.
No mames, wey. God damn.
And on to the next stop.
Ya pues regresamos, esta ya no va a traigar.
Pero quería sonar.
Nah, también perras, pero.
Están perras.
Guys, aquí andamos con el compa Corbetoys Juan.
Es en la siguiente, wey.
Ah, cabrón.
Ay,
¿qué?
No, sí.
¿Sí está acá o no? Guys, el Corbetoys anda fallando. ¿Por qué lo trajo para acá, Juan?
No, es del asiento nada más. Acuérdate que el asiento le estaba fallando.
¿Pero ya se lo arreglaron?
Ya lo arreglaron, ya. Ya quedó. Bueno, quedó un lado, ahora falta el otro.
Bueno, guys, aquí andamos con el compa Juan. Y ahorita vamos a ir a ver un carro que mucha gente pregunta. Mucho. So, we're gonna take the drive. Es about, ¿qué? ¿Unos 40 minutes?
Right now, creo que es una hora o something.
Pero. We're gonna go take a ride. Y vamos a ver, hopefully, we can get an update on the car. You guys will stay tuned. Well, no, you guys are gonna know by the time you see the thumbnail. Vamos a ir a ver el mamalón Honda All-Wheel Drive, a ver cómo está.
Irá, ¿dónde lo tienen?
A la verga, Juan. ¿Le dan special treatment?
No, creo que se lo lavaron, mira.
¿Así se lo lavaron, Juanito,
VIP?
¡El VIP! ¡VIP! Mira, güey. No, hombre, qué verga, le lavaron. Está todo chorreado de acá, mira, presiona.
No, padre.
Está todo chorreado, pues. Aquí lo esperamos, Juanito.
Dale.
¿Cómo ves, Tony? Vamos a ir a ver a Honda.
Ah, toda madre. Quiero ver. A ver si le hicieron algo. Pero fíjate ahorita que lo prenda, güey. Esa madre.
Entonces, pásenle ya. Ajá. Guys, el carro de Juan tiene un cold start, pero exagerado. Yo la verdad, güey, pensé que Juan le pisaba el acelerador y luego lo prendía, pero no es así, guys. Nomás lo prende y se escucha, pero exageradamente recio. Ahorita vamos a ver ahorita para que miren cómo se escucha todo el pinche. Ahí viene Juan, güey.
Ya lo regañaron, güey.
No va a prender un chico. No está el vato, ya se fue el vato.
Ahorita que meter la llave.
¿Qué le dijeron?
Ah, ya está listo.
Le dijeron, púchalo allá hasta la calle y lo prende allá lejos.
Sí, sí, ahorita cuando se. Se prende el pinche ruidazo, que ahí se encierra el ruido bien cabrón ahí.
Ya me fue. A ver el costar, Juanito.
No manches, hubieran sido como unos $2,000.
¿Por qué?
Por el motor y por el labor y eso.
A ver, vamos a escuchar cómo prende. Prende el pinche mamalosísimo. Se van a cagar todo.
Todos salen aquí. No. Pinche pedo.
¿Qué? Juan, está exagerado ese pedo, Juan. Póngale unos pinches tapones ahí.
Vámonos.
Vámonos.
A la verga, me espanté.
Pensé que venía a subir arriba con los TRX. Y de ahí ya salió el vato. No te estás sumando tu chingadera.
El Corvetoy.
Sí, se escucha bien recio, ¿verdad, güey?
Uh-huh. La madre se ve como el Hellcat.
Ni el Hellcat se escucha tan recio. Few inches later. Hijo de la chingada, güey. Se va a apagar esa madre.
No sé, pero se escucha como el otro pedo, güey.
Uy, güey. ¡Dele, Juan, dele! Si se pone la luz roja, se la pasa, Juan. No se apure, yo lo pucho. Ahorita lo vamos a puchar para...
Para TRX.
Ahí está una reca, güey, no pasa nada. Que lo lleve de ahí a allí.
Ey, güey, se viene quedando sin gas, Juan, güey. Juan Paca, sin gas.
Ey, la cagamos.
Sí. Sí nos dijo. ¿Eh?
No, así es el gas.
Es el gas, Juan. Ahorita viene con cuatro cilindros.
Pero se oye bien alterado, Juan.
Se escucha que trae un cam, pero así, un pinche cam. Se escucha que trae el mother tarp.
Un dumper cam.
No, güey. Hasta la vuelta rebote, ¿no, güey?
No, así le... No.
¿Qué?
Es que piensa que es otro pedo.
No, es el gas, Juan, pues no trae gas. Antes diga que pobrecito carro anda corriendo con los... Anda chupando con popote, ¿ya?
Los puros fumes.
Sí, ¿sabes? Como cuando lo sprayas así con un bote así como de... Así anda ahorita el güey, chupando puros fumes.
Pinche ghost can.
Pero dice Juan, yo lo traigo sin mucho gas por si corro. Ándele, güey. Llénelo ahorita, Juan, déjense de mamadas. Si le van a ganar, le van a ganar.
Que no se vaya como un VA.
No mames, esta madre parece un pinche tractor, güey.
A la madre, está un pinche cherife ahí. Voy a decir esto.
Que es que la gente está corriendo, güey. No le
voy a estar ahí, güey. ¿Cómo se escucha? De traer un sistema bien perro. ¡Llénalo, Juanito!
Ahorita vamos a oír la si cambia de volada.
Sí. ¿Era para que se hubiera compuesto?
No, pero chance la computadora está mandando señales que low hue todavía. ¡Llénalo! Ya, ahora sí, ¿ya? ¡Bravo!
Era un pinche gas, ¿ya?
¡Ey! Pues ya como que trae un pinche Big Block.
Parecía un pinche tractor de granja, güey.
¡No, me Juan!
¡La güey, la
fiesta! ¡Teddy! Te mandé un mensaje y te dijo, ¡ey! ¡Párese por tu besito gas! Y yo te mandé otro y yo dije, ¡no!
Cuando pase, si hable, no sé, párese, güey, mames. Nosotros ni en cuenta veníamos de enverguiza. Pero dígale, Juan, ¿por qué no le echa gas?
Ah, no, porque siempre ando corriendo. Y necesito echar poquito gas.
Por poquito y no corría ya el puto carro.
Ey, pero esta madre como que apagó los pistones, güey, ¿eh?
Apagó cuatro pistones y andaba con todo.
No, decía que cuatro, decía.
Sí,
ahí no,
en serio, decía cuatro. ¿Has mirado el video del vato que sale así? ¿Te has mirado el TikTok? El vato que sale así, que estaba amadible así. Y está otro vato allá, y está
16 galones, siempre le caben 14.
Llénelo a la verga, Juan, déjate tomar. Ahorita es la pena.
Otro carro se hubiera apagado ya, güey.
Sí, fácil.
Se hubiera apagado.
No trae buen sistema esa madre, porque...
Imagínate.
Dejó de trabajar cuatro pistones.
Para ¿y que si lo más... grabaste cómo estaba sonando?
Sí.
No, hombre, Juan, parecía tractor, se escuchaba bien culero.
Con la raza de haber dicho que...
No tenía bien cagón, así, no sé si es el gas, se siente bien feo.
ibas a parquear Corvette.
Pinche Corvette cabe donde quiera. Pedo con la TRX. No, le iba a parquear yo allá.
Alright, guys. Es mejor recordar a Varga.
Miren, joven, aquí es donde está el famosísimo Honda que todos preguntan. Está allá atrás.
Ahorita lo va a ver.
Ya había venido yo acá.
¿Eh?
Ya había venido para acá, sí. Bueno, no al taller, no que. No porque estaba aquí.
¿No estaba bien habitado?
No,
ya lo pasaron, güey. ¿No está nadie, güey?
Ah.
Mire,
Juan.
No mames, güey, está igual.
¿Sí?
No he hecho nada.
Shit.
Yo pensé ver otros updates. No, pues vamos adentro, vamos a preguntar. Damn. Está cabrón, Juan,
eh. Sí. Y este.
Ya tiene Rocky, está andando bueno.
¿Y este es el motor o qué?
No, hombre, es un motor más verga.
¿Y dónde está el motor?
Todavía no. No sé por qué se pone el proyecto, pero vamos a investigar. Pues ¿pero por qué? Sure. ¿No está nadie, güey? ¿Por qué? No va. ¿Ves que este Juan, güey? No creo,
¿eh?
Oh, sí está Juan.
Hey,
Mr. Juan.
Hey.
How's it going, man? We came to buy some parts. A ver si me dice lo bueno que está. How's it going, honey?
Yeah.
How you been?
Sorry for the communication.
Oh, no, it's okay.
Yeah.
I'm hoping we can continue with the
build. Yeah, we are.
I know you were out of town for a while, right? Yeah. A lot of people have been asking about it.
Yeah,
so
I know.
I'm like, might as well come, tell you, so you can let us know what's going on. Yeah. I know you were out of town, you were taking care of some family issues.
Yeah.
And it's time to move with the car, move with the build.
Yeah.
So
then we can give it so we can talk about the new ideas.
Okay.
Yeah.
Something. I mean, maybe the route where we're going, maybe it's a little bit complicated.
Well, it's not. It's just that we have a better solution with it.
Okay.
With the GTR motor.
Okay.
It bolts right up.
So okay.
That's what we've been working on.
So, all right.
I'll have a give a talk to you about it.
Sounds good. Sounds good, Mr. Hunt. Yeah. We're gonna take a look around and then we'll wait for you. Okay.
Right.
Sounds good. Was I that way? Sí, había hablado yo y me habían dicho que estaba arrastrando. La gente, mucha gente ha preguntado, más es mejor decides que estaba ocupado, a lo mejor estaba arrastrando en el family business. Y ahorita ya vamos a ver qué es lo que se va a hacer from today on. Imagínate con un GTR motor.
No,
miren, guys, esta es la tienda, la famosísima tienda. Aquí nos trajo el compa Woody. Cuando nosotros conocimos esa tienda por el compa Woody que nos trajo. Y la mera neta, cuando llegamos aquí, sentimos como que entramos a un episodio de Fast and the Furious. ¿Cómo ve aquí, Juanito? ¿Cómo se ve?
Sí, chingo de partes. Aquí están todas las partes.
¿Dice que usted había venido hasta acá, Juan?
Sí, ya hace unos 2 años. Yo venía para acá. No, venía aquí a una clínica que está aquí de ladito.
Oh.
Y estaba esperando mi morra y por aquí pasaba y miré en caliente me metí.
No, aquí cuando se me entra se siente como Fast and Furious.
Sí.
No, está bien chingón. ¿Cómo ves, Dani? ¿A qué te recuerda esto?
Es a lot of parts for
mira, güey, aquí está el mío, güey. ¿Sabes qué ocupo, güey? Los side skirts para el amarillo mío. Se le cayó. Ese también, el carbon fiber, se mira bien perro. Danny está en shock.
¿Ya de una vez una collaboration?
¿Collaboration? ¿Cómo ve, Juanito? Dice que ya tiene otra solución para el fondo, Juan.
Sí.
So, a lo mejor el plan que teníamos no va a jalar. Vamos a hacerle algo diferente para que.
Pero ahora sí ya.
No, pues es que andaba afuera, andaba haciendo cosas así, taking care of business, pero ya regresó y
por eso Honda están preguntando, ¿eh?
No, en todos los videos, guys. Yo sé, por eso vinimos hoy. Se mira que Mr. Juan estaba un poco, como que da vergüenza, da pena, pero pues hay veces que pasan cosas con la familia o así, o problemas que tienes que solucionar y un proyecto de un carro no es prioridad. ¿Sí me entiende? So, vamos a ver qué es lo que sigue de aquí. A lo mejor ocupamos dar más feria para que siga el build. O whatever, so ahorita vamos a hablar.
Ocupo unos de estos para la mía.
¿Para
cuál? Para la
C10. Pero mira, güey, hay como este se mira que es reclinable y todo.
Ya.
Porque agarra los que no se mueven, no vale ver. Mira.
R36.
Okay.
Audi.
Okay.
You saw the motor on the Audi out there?
No. Let's go check it out.
I thought you said R.
Alright guys, so my boy Gilbert is gonna explain to us what's gonna happen now. What route will we take?
So this is an R motor.
It's an R motor. Yeah. This is what?
This is a R 30. So it's a 3-liter six cylinder. But it's a six cylinder and 15 degrees. That's why you only have one head. You have one intake manifold and then you have one exhaust manifold.
Okay, so okay.
Pretty much it's gonna be the same thing. But instead of being a 3-liter, it's gonna be a 3.6, which is the R36, because they have the R32 and then the R36, which is the highest displacement V6 motor that they have.
And these are Audi engines, right?
These are Audi Volkswagen motors. Okay. You'll find them on Touaregs, Q7s, a lot of cars, Passats. They use that motor in several different cars from Audi.
All right. Yeah, well, we're gonna use that motor, the Audi transmission, and it's gonna be turbo. How much power do you think that's gonna put down?
Tell me how much power you want.
Let me boy. 2,000 horsepower.
Just put it this way. This guy is gonna be putting 1,500, 1,400 horsepower.
Oh, no shit. Yeah.
And it's a 3-liter.
And this one's built or it's?
Fully built.
Fully built. Okay.
Fully built. Forged pistons, rods, ordering block, everything.
Okay.
Everything. This guy's a halted. I mean, the guy built it himself, but we had to fix a couple of stuff. But with your vehicle, you tell me how much power you want. And then
I just want something. I don't want to say reliable, because I mean, nothing built and turbo is reliable, but something that's not going to break.
The advantage of going with a big motor, the bigger the motor, the more reliable it becomes, a higher power. Because it's not the same as pushing, let's say, 1,000 horsepower on a 2.4 cylinder than on a V6. Even though it looks like a straight six, it's still a V6.
Yeah.
So it's more power. So it takes the pounding better.
And then you're gonna have to build brackets and all that stuff for this car, right?
Well, big advantage of this one is that we don't have to get anything CNC custom made to adapt the K24 to the DSG transmission. This is straight bolt on. If something breaks, literally we can get one from the JR, replace it, and go back to the road. There's no waiting time of, I need to get another CNC plate built, or we don't have to build two of each. So it makes things more simple.
Yeah. All right, well shit, man. Can we put like a time frame on the build? That way we have something more or less, you think, 3-4 months, 5 months to be complete and out?
To be complete 6 months? I don't think so, man. It's like the thing is, I'm the one who does all the stuff.
Yeah.
And so there's so much work that the guys can do. And breaking myself in this project here,
and then tuning. I understand.
I need to, spread my time and set like a goal each month. All right, this month I want to have this amount of work done in this car, in this car. That way, in this case, we're talking about your car, so. I will need to sit down with Han and come up with a plan.
Yeah.
See, all right, this is the amount of work we have. We need to dedicate this much time in this part. This is as much as I can get done in this month.
Yeah.
That way we can come up with like a realistic time frame.
Yeah.
And we did get rid of a lot of the bigger project that has been sitting around. It's gone, so we're in pretty good shape now.
Okay. Yeah, I don't want to pressure you guys. I mean, maybe 7-8 months, maybe.
Somewhere around there.
Yeah. Okay, well, I mean, as long as we see progress whenever we show up or whatever, I think it'll be good,
we'll
call
you time to time.
Come record something here or there, just so people can get, because we came, and everybody was like, hey, excited about it, and then we left, and,
Totally
a lot of people were asking about it. I was sending Han, I wasn't even worried about the car, but a lot of people were just commenting, and I know some people come here, they're like, hey, I was over there, and I was thinking about your car, and I'm like, dude.
Believe it or not, there's a huge, the market on the import scene.
So, you know, yeah, so a lot of people, like, especially when they see JR's car, they're like, hey, so when is this going to be out? So you can raise JR and this and that. So I'm like, you know what? I'm going to take the drive today. I actually said it on a couple of videos ago. Next week, I'm going to go and I'm going to check it out. So that's why we're here. Not because I'm worried about the car. We got plenty of cars that we drive and we race. But I mean, it is a unique build and people are waiting on it. So,
of course.
I don't want you guys to be like, you know. But so yeah, I mean, that's good. Yeah, I mean, if you think this is gonna be a better route than doing the K24.
For simplicity's sake, is yes. But nowadays, a K swap is like a LS swap. Everybody has one.
Yeah.
So uniqueness on that, the only unique part about it was that about the DSG that nobody has. But at the end of the day, it's a K series and everybody has it.
Yeah.
So.
So it's still gonna be unique because we have a Volkswagen motor, Audi motor, and now we have the DSG still with the Audi
still
trans,
the DSG,
and it's still gonna be all-wheel drive.
It's still gonna be all-wheel drive.
Yeah. All right.
So pretty much we'll be drivetrain all Audi.
Cause man, JR's car, I think his is pushing like 700 horsepower, and man, it's hard to beat that guy. We don't have nothing fast enough. Well, I got like my Ford, and I got like the Lambo, but the Lambo's broken right now. But man, all the other shit we got is like he's like one of the fastest ones right now. So everybody like, get your Honda so you can beat it, cause your Honda's gonna be 1,000 horsepower. You know what I'm saying? All wheel drive. That's why everybody's worried about. Now
we'll
get it up there. That's the update. Now we're going a different route and hopefully the car is done. If it takes 8 months or whatever, as long as it gets done, I think it'll be good. That's the update. So it's going to look something like this whenever it's set up.
Turbo is going to be same size.
Intake
manifold will be different, of course, because this is longitudinal motor. Yours is going to be transverse, so the manifold is going to be different.
And you're gonna fabricate all that, right?
The manifold, that's another thing. There's plenty of places in Europe that they already have a billet intake manifold that we can buy. The only thing I'm gonna fab is gonna be the
headers?
The exhaust manifold, All the turbo side and the intercooler piping, all that, we're gonna have to fab it in-house. But the intake manifold, I mean, there's already there, so.
Yeah.
That will cut time. On it.
Well, built motor and everything, I mean, I guess the most power we can squeeze out of it, but still, like I said, I just don't want something.
On this motor,
because I know the trans can hold a lot of power, right?
The transmission with the clutch kit that we put on it is good for about 1,200 horses.
Okay.
Not unbreakable, but it will handle the abuse.
Yeah.
Eventually, it's going to, after so much abuse, of course, something is going to break.
It's going to wear,
Big advantage is that there's already parts. Upgrades.
I think if we leave it like at 800, 850, 900, I think that'll be good. I think that'll be more than enough.
Well, we can turn up the boost.
Yeah. Right? And then, I mean, we could always turn it up and maybe do like two or three settings.
With the ECU that we're going to be using, Cybex, I can set you up with the steering wheel.
Like different maps?
I can set you, you touch up a button, I can give you up to 12 maps.
Oh, like the Lambo?
Yeah, exactly, like the Lambo. So you each press a button and it'll switch the map on the fly. So you can go, let's say the least amount of power it makes is 600, that'll be your bottom bracket.
Okay.
And let's say we squeeze 400, that'll be your kill mode. So depending on the button, do we have the steering wheel we're going to be using on the MPA? I'll show you the steering wheel right now.
Okay.
So with buttons, I can put a kill mode button. Press one button and it gives you automatically all the juice.
Yeah.
And I can give you another button where you can select the map. So everything will be here on the steering wheel.
Okay.
So that's the advantage. You're not gonna be running the car at 200 all the time. You can run it at 600. If nobody beats you at 600, you're fucking 600.
Yeah.
Whenever somebody beats you, you go to the next step.
Yeah. No, that'd be good. I think this route that we're going, if it's a little bit more simple, it should be.
It's a lot more simple.
Yeah. And because I know the other one, you have to shave down the block and do this and that.
Yeah, look, we shave on block. Come here. We shave a block and everything.
Oh, yeah, I see. That's just, a K20
block. Yeah, just to clear the transfer case, we had to fucking shave this. So I was like thinking, it's like, what if something happened to the motor? We get another 4P motor and then we have to do all of this work.
Yeah.
If something happens to that motor, we don't have to do shit to the transmission.
Yeah.
Because this is straight bolt on.
Mm-hmm.
And there is, let's say we max out the 6-speed. we can always get the TQ500, which is the 7-speed. That 7-speed is the same transmission that the RS3 are using.
Uh-huh.
And the Audi TT RSs.
Yeah.
That transmission, so I've seen cars.
Yeah, those 15. Cars are fast. The Audi TT RS is the Audi ones, right?
Yeah, the Audi. Yeah,
the one that they had over there at Sheepy. Yeah, those are fast. Well,
there's a couple of guys swapping the VR6 motor
into
the Audi, the RS3, making up to 1500 horsepower.
Damn. So what year car motor is that?
That's like the
oh, thing. This is nice.
Hell yeah. And then there's another one with a screen in here too.
Mm-hmm.
When that time
and then
comes,
the power will be able to click that button like this.
Yeah. Plus you'll have paddle shifters.
Oh, nice.
Kind of like
the Lambo. It makes it like the Lambo then.
Like the Lambo.
That'd be dope, man.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Well, there it is, guys. Let's get to it. Here's the Honda. It still has the cage and everything, right?
Yeah. We came and opened it a while ago. And we'll eventually get to drive it.
A couple months, guys, maybe, like you said, 6 to 8 months.
And we'll be dragging
the shit out of this car.
Drag trip and on the street.
It's going to be safety, guys, to have the cage and everything.
It's going to be good when it's done.
Damn it, boy. ¿Cómo ves, Dani? What you think with the new setup? ¿Cómo? What you think? ¿Va a jalar bien?
Yo siento que pues aquí ya le saben más o menos, ¿da?
Sí.
Pues si, ¿cuánto? ¿Unos 8 meses?
Va a valer la pena. Si ya nos esperamos otros 8 meses, no va a ser diferencia.
Va a valer la pena la espera.
Va a ser la guerra contra esta, ya cuando esté este...
Supercharge,
el de Juanito.
¿Cómo ves el carro, Juan? El color está bien perro.
Sí.
Este no es cualquier Honda, este es un Honda SR.
¿Oh, sí?
Sí. Usted lo ve y tirado las cucarachas, pero este carro
va a estar... Este carro cuando salga, Juan, va a estar inmaculate. De hasta adentro lo van a pintar y todo. Vamos a tomar una foto para todos, guys. Y pues nos vamos para dejarlos aquí. A ver, no te la dejan para que salga todo el carro. Big things happening with the Mamalon, right?
Yeah,
Mamalon. Yeah, the Mamalon is going to be out, like they said, 6 to 8 months. They're going to take the time, do it right, and we're going to be out there with at least 800-900 horsepower or 1,000. Man, the sky's the limit.
Yes.
Right? Well, let's see. Let's go back to the headquarters, man, because that fucking 5 o'clock traffic ain't no joke. Yeah. Man, he almost ran out of gas on the way over here.
Alrighty, guys. Next time we go and eat and get drunk.
Oh, all right. Yeah.
That's true.
Guys, ya empezó a fallar el carrito de Juan.
Otra vez va con 4 cilindros.
Otra vez va con 4 cilindros y dice Juan que no era el gas.
¿Mira?
O sea que hay mame diferente.
No mames, güey. Y ya nos queda un pedazote para llegar para allá.
Ah, cabrón. A lo mejor si lo apaga y lo prende, jala, güey. Te voy a dar un puchón, güey.
No, güey. Esa madre está bien.
A mí sí me manda, no.
Es puro, güey.
Oh, es que como que le falla ya después de rato que lo anda manejando, ¿verdad?
Mira, otra vez. ¿Qué le pasó, Juan?
No, ¿sabes qué? Me dijeron que como el empaque de la...
Sí.
Empieza a detectar ese liqueo y es por eso que hace eso.
De los del oxígeno, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Oiga, ahorita que le quieren dar chicharrón.
Mira.
¿Y su carro que no corre, pues? Está como la Honda que tengo ya.
No me la chingaron
de
nada.
Sí, Juan. Ay, cabrón.
Ah, no, cabrón, ahí va el pinche constable. Espérense, Juan, no te cagando el palo, ahí va el policía al lado.
No vaya tan recio, vaya a ser más,
no,
ahí más
adelante. Calmado, Juan, para que no detecte ahí.
Sí.
Sí, y mira, si no, ahorita se vuelve a parar, le voy a dar un pinche puchón con la TRX.
No, no,
así
estamos bien.
Ya
no,
está, Juan. No, aquí me voy a ir atrás de usted como quiera por si se le chinga. Guys, so, ahorita vamos a entrar a la tienda y vamos a, I know we have a lot of new followers, so, vamos a explicarles qué onda con el Honda. Porque muchos no saben, van a mirar este video y van a decir, ey, ese pinche carro, qué pedo. Vamos a explicarles ahorita en unos cortos instantes.
Several bad puns later.
All right, guys, so, ya llegamos a Ketchup. Now, right now, aquí estamos con Woody. Woody went with us, I don't really recall all the dates, this and that, whatever.
Was, like, I told Han. I used to work here.
I told, yeah. I told Han, I'm like, I'm not worried about the car. You know, we got plenty of shit that we could raise, a bunch of cars. But it is important for them to finish it because everybody's like, they really want to see that car out. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's a special car because it is a SI, it is a Honda, and it is something different. It's going to be all-wheel drive. It's going to be big power. So everybody wants that car to come out so we can do what we do.
Yeah.
And you know what I'm saying? That's what we do. We go out and we do our thing with the car.
And that car was supposed to be built to where that can hang out with the Lambo. That's how bad that car was supposed to be.
Yeah. No, más que for some reason or another, it took a little bit longer, but I know I have a lot of new followers.
Yeah.
That car was taken when Woody was working here. That was what, like a year ago? About two years ago. So we took that car, we had a whole plan, we dropped it off, they started working on it right away. Yeah. They put the roll cage, they did this, they did that, and then it just came to a halt. I don't know, a lo mejor it got a little bit difficult. What they were trying to do was a little bit different.
I think at the time COVID was going on too and stuff like that, which we understand that happens, but it's been 2 years now. I think it's time that we got to see a little more progress than what we've seen the first couple of months.
Yeah, so we went back today. Woody doesn't know, he just got here. I'm telling Woody because he was there whenever we dropped it out. I'm not good with dates or whatever. So now they're doing a different setup. They're gonna do Audi motor with the Audi transmission, all-wheel drive, and everything else. So I said, okay, you know what? It's good. It should be like 900 to 1,000 horsepower. And I'm pretty sure they know what they're doing. So yeah, guys. So for the people that don't know, we bought that car. I actually bought that car from Woody.
Yeah, that was my original EM1 with the. I forgot what electric blue it's called.
Yeah. So I bought that car from Woody. It was one of the first cars that we were actually like, okay, we're gonna do like a full build. I think we did that car before King Cobra, no?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So that was one of the first cars that we were like, oh, it's gonna be like a race car, like a road cage and everything. We took it over there, and well, you guys seen what happened. A lot of people don't know, but that car, like I'm saying, it was supposed to be like a full build. It's supposed to be like a car that was gonna hang with like Lambos and stuff, and we were gonna race a lot of people with it, but unfortunately things didn't go as planned. Now, like I said, it's important to me, but it's not something that I can live without, you know what I'm saying? So now that if you guys are seeing this for the first time, you guys may have seen a lot of people comment down in the comment section, where's your blue Honda? That's the blue Honda everybody's been talking about. And that's the reason I went today over there, because I've been getting that comment all the time. I put a post, JR comes out with his Honda, and everybody like, where's your Honda? And everybody wants to see that car, so that's why we went over there today. So hopefully from now on, things start moving a little bit faster than what they have been.
And maybe I think you should go up there and like, you know, make yourself known.
More present, yeah. I mean, everybody wants to. I don't like pressuring people like that, like going over there and, hey, what's up with my car? Especially since it's not a short drive, and I know it's gonna get boring. It's gonna get repetitive that we go over there. You want to go, I mean, the first time we went, we saw the roll cage and we saw the motor getting mocked up. We saw the all-wheel drive setup, so it was exciting. But after that, it just came to a little stop. So now we're gonna start going back again, guys. That, like I said, like they explained right there, that's gonna be a car that's gonna be from 900 to 1,000 horsepower, all-wheel drive, which is super badass, super lightweight. It's gonna be a lot lighter than the Lambo. The Lambo's 1500, that one's gonna be 900 or 1,000, so they should be like a good heads up race with the Lambo. I mean, you guys see those cars racing against Lambos, all-wheel drive setups, and they're like, they're neck to neck. A little bit less power, but the weight difference makes up for it, so.
The ratio between the weight and the power just makes all for it.
So guys, for the people that are seeing this for the first time, you guys will start seeing that car more often. Me and Danny have planned probably going at least once a month. They said it might take about 6 months to get the car built, 6 months to 8 months.
You said something about an Audi? Audi motor?
Audi motor, yeah. It's Audi, Volkswagen, Audi motor, I don't know what it is.
Okay. That's new to me. I thought that we're gonna go K.
I thought, then they said that it was gonna be a Skyline motor, so I thought it was gonna, but then I guess they were wrong.
Right now we just want the car back.
I don't want the car back, I want the car built.
We want the car running, that way we can show it on the vlog.
So, I mean, Han is a really nice guy, I respect the guy, and he's really cool and everything. He probably had more important things to worry about than a Honda built, you know what I'm saying? So I understand that, and from now on we're gonna be a little bit more intuitive, like more into the build, that way they can see that we really want the car built.
A little more interested in everything like that in the car.
So stay tuned, guys. The car's gonna be badass when it's done. They explained to us that they're gonna get the motor mocked up. Once they have everything mocked up, they're gonna pull everything out. We're gonna pull the car as a rolling chassis, bring it to Exclusive, have them paint it, and then we're gonna bring it back to them so they can put the motor, transmission, and do all the wiring and everything else. So it's gonna be a while, it's gonna be a long process, but it's gonna be done hopefully within 8 months.
But at least you guys will see the car on the vlog. And getting updates constantly, you know, once a month.
¿Qué traes, vale?
¿Huh?
¿Dónde me donamos, vale? So yeah. Ya fuimos a ver el carrillo, güey.
¿Qué? ¿Cómo vieron?
Da igual.
Pero
nada, ya hablamos con Juan y dice que le van a echar ganas. So dice que como 6 a 8 meses. Ojalá ya va a estar.
No, le había dicho, ¿cuál es? 6 a 8 meses. No. 2 meses.
Ah, no mames.
Va. No. Entonces luego.
No. Eso es algo diferente.
Es que le vale ese chingo la C10. No, una semana.
Un fin de semana desarmó y armó la C10. No, pero es que es otro pedo ese. No quieres personas porque luego se sale algo. Sí. Como ahorita me preguntó el vato, me dijo, hey, ¿qué turbo quieres? Dije, yo no quiero decirte qué turbo le pongas, porque si subes al dyno y no hace 900, vas a decir que es por el turbo. Dije, tú escoge lo que tú quieras, ponle todo lo que tú quieras. Que él sepa, porque es lo que pasa en veces.
Sí.
Le dices, hey, no uses esto, usa esto, y luego si no jala como quieren, es por esto.
O si le dicen un más grande, va a tener mucho lag, va a decir, no es pelo rápido, es que tú me dijiste este.
So yo le dije, tú haz el setup que tú sabes, y que jale con madre el carro, and that's what they're gonna do. So ojalá ya va a tener Hondita para atrás, ponle que un año, güey. En un año todavía está bien. As long as we go y miramos que está todo con madre.
I mean, usually the thing is you build your cars fast. Like you build the Lambo quick, like what?
In 1 week. But I mean, they weren't getting engine and transmission and everything. You know?
Yeah, but like that's what I'm saying. Like usually projects do take a while when you're doing a whole build. So I mean, I'd understand, but that's why people want updates on the car.
Se chingó el Lambo y todo, pero en una semana it was ready. We literally, pero es diferente, es un poquito diferente, you know? Ya trae motor, transmission, it was just.
Well, I'm saying that's what the people are used to.
Especially when we're on YouTube, guys. YouTube videos, everybody wants to build boom, 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 boom. Paint, motor, transmission, y pa fuera, wheels, drop, y todo,
All in one episode.
In one episode, But it's not like that. That shit takes a little bit long. Pero no, hopefully everything goes smooth from now on, and you guys will see more of that Mamalona K. No, ya no puedo decir K.
Mamalona. EM1. It's still an EM1.
El Mamalona Honda Civic. El blue one.